Jai Hind children, hope you all are doing fine at home. So we had already started this chapter, history's first chapter, Tracing Changes Through a Thousand Years, and we have done two modules. And in the previous module we had discussed about the historians and the various sources that they use. We also discussed about archives where manuscripts were collected and kept. So, continuing further, we'll be dealing with a new topic, new social and political groups. So, the study of 1000 years between 1700 to 1750 is a huge challenge for the historians, because during this time, a large scale or we can say a variety of developments had occurred. At different moments in this period, new technologies had emerged, like the Persian wheel, in irrigation, the spinning wheel in weaving, and firearms in combat. New food and beverages also arrived in the subcontinent, like potato, chili, tea, coffee, and these things led to a period of huge economic, political, social, and cultural changes. This was also a period of great mobility. And groups of people traveled from one place to another in search of opportunity, because the subcontinent had huge, or we can say, possibilities or opportunities it offered for people to make a fortune for themselves. One group of people who became very important in this period were the Rajputs, and this name is derived from Rajputra, or the son of a ruler. Now, these people were great warriors, and they claimed as themselves as Kshatriya caste, and the term included not just the rulers and the chieftains, but also the soldiers and commanders who had served in the armies. These people were known for extreme valor, and they had great sense of loyalty, and poets have also always been singing about these people. Other people, or other groups of people, like the Marathas, the Sikhs, the Jats, they also used the opportunities of the age to become political more important. And what are the things that changed? Throughout this period, there was a gradual clearing of the forest. And what happened? The forest dwellers moved from the forest, and agriculture had started. A new peasant group started to emerge. Then chieftains, priests, we could see people coming. They became part of a large complex society. Some people possessed more productive land, others kept cattle, and some combined both productive work as well as artisanal work. Society became differentiated, and then people were divided into jatis or subcastes and ranked on the basis of their backgrounds. Ranks were not fixed permanently, and they varied according to the power, influence, and the resources which was controlled by the members of the jatis. Now, these jatis, they framed their own rules and regulations to manage the conduct of their members. These regulations were enforced by an assembly of elders, described in some areas as the jati panchayat. But the jatis were required to follow the rules of their villages. Several villages were governed by a chieftain, and together they were one small unit of a state. Next is region and empire. So, large states like the Cholas, the Mughals, they encompassed many regions. A Sanskrit Parahasti, which praising the Delhi Sultan Yasuddin Balban, explained that he was the ruler of a very vast empire that stretched from Bengal in the east to Ghazni in Afghanistan in the west, and included all of South India. So what happened? People of different regions like Goa and Kerala, Karnataka, Maharashtra, they fled from his armies. Now, historians regard this as exaggerated claims of conquest, and at the same time, they try to understand why rulers kept claiming to have control over different parts of the subcontinent. So this is for the third module. We'll be discussing about it in the live class till then. Jai Hind.